In this video, we're going to talk about how to use the Sony XM4s with an iPhone.
You have to go to the App Store and download an app called Headphones First by Sony, and then the process is seamless. All you have to do is open the app, hit the connect button, turn on the headphones, and then you don't even have to go into the settings app to set these up. All happens within the app. I really like these headphones. That's probably why you're watching this video. You're wondering, okay, why should I get these instead of Bose or the AirPods Max or the Beats Studio? Well, the app for these and the amount of control that you have over these headphones with an iPhone is superior to the AirPods Max, to the Bose Noise Cancelling 700s, to anything else that we've seen out there. Sony has the most in-depth app. So let's talk about the app first, because I'm assuming that you've watched other reviews that talk about the actual sound quality of these and probably the noise cancellation features, which are fabulous. We're not saying that they're not. All right, let's open up the app. Here we go. Just going to talk you through it. Let's tap on headphones. We can see here, AAC DSEE Extreme. DSEE Extreme is Sony's artificial intelligence technology that intelligently optimizes compressed audio files and other things that you might be listening to, makes it sound better. All right, adaptive sound control, I leave off because that's gonna dynamically change the volume. I don't want that to happen. Tap on sound, and this is where it starts to get cool. I think I need to put on the headphones to be able to show you the rest of it. I like these headphones. Very comfortable.
Very comfortable, pretty light. And they're up there with the AirPods Max and the Bose 700s in terms of really top-of-the-line, high-quality audio headphones that aren't necessarily for audiophiles.
Ambient sound control is kind of like transparency mode that you might see on Beats or AirPods Max. Right now I can hear the outside. Check 1, 2. David sounds real clear. But then the more I slide this, 20 different levels of noise canceling, now I can hardly hear anything.
Can you hear me now?
What?
Throw back to that Sprint commercial.
Yeah.
Or maybe it was with Verizon.
So I've already gone through the noise canceling optimizer. That's really cool. The way it works is it plays back these different sounds in your headphones and then automatically adjusts them. And all of a sudden, you can hear a different noise canceling sort of profile and other sounds disappear. Very cool. Automatic takes 20 seconds. Really not that long. Equalizer. Pretty much the most in-depth EQ that we've seen on headphones. Bose, the 700s have bass, mid, and treble. This has a 5-band EQ along with a bass control, and I think that that's really cool because with the Bose, you really don't have that much control over which frequencies you are boosting. 360 reality audio setup. I was a little bit disappointed about this, but the analysis of this was really cool because like it has you hold your head in the frame and then turn your head. That it takes a picture of your ear automatically, and then you do it the other way. It takes a picture of your ear, and then it creates this 3D audio sound.
Mm-hmm. This is where the AirPods Max really stands out, in my opinion, with the spatial audio stuff.
Right, and it's really not even comparable. Mm-hmm. 360 reality audio is only available from these music service apps. 360 by Deezer, Artist Connection, Nugs.net, and Tidal. I've been using Tidal recently. I like it, but that's the only, you know, the only stuff that could be optimized with this audio. Whereas the AirPods Max, if you're watching a movie, it's amazing as long as you're watching it on your AirPod, on your iPad.
On your iPad or iPhone, yeah.
Thank you. So many pods and pads. All right, tap close down here. I want to skip. I already did it for Tidal. Sound quality mode. This is the ability to select whether you want to have a stable connection if it starts cutting off. I've never had that problem with these. And then the DSEE Extreme is on auto. And then over here on system, connects up to 2 devices. There are all sorts of controls for the sensor controls. This morning, it automatically updated the software. Really an awesome integration with the iPhone. Connects automatically. Pretty much as seamless as the AirPods Pro. One more step, you have to download the app. But then you get all this control and you don't really get that with the Apple headphones or the Bose headphones. Can I take these off?
Go for it, yeah, whatever you want.
All right, these are great. Wow, it sounds so different.
That's
amazing.
Noise canceling. That's industry-leading noise canceling, according to Sony. I don't think so, no.
Okay, good.
Yeah, Sony claims that they're the best noise-canceling headphones. We're not so sure about that, but they're really good headphones. We also recommend the Bose 700. It's similar price range.
Yep.
Maybe a little bit better overall in terms of quality, in our opinion, but...
Yeah, in terms of sound, maybe a little bit better.
Yeah.
But if you are a techie and you like Sony stuff and you like the ability to really tweak as much as you possibly can on headphones using an app on your iPhone, these are the ones to get. And you won't be disappointed with the sound quality.
Yep, that is how to use the Sony XM4s on an iPhone. Thanks for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Leave any other comments or questions down below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more great videos about headphones.